guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm glad you found your way over because today I want to talk about a very special book I only finished reading last night, and that is Olive by Emma Gannon. I think this book was so special because it talks about a subject that I have the feeling is not openly talked about, or it is a subject around which there are still a lot of prejudice out there, and that is the active decision of women not to have children. This book tells the story of the protagonist Olive when she's in her mid-30s in her early 30s, and she decides that she does not want to have children, basically. And the amount of stress, struggle, anxiety, etc. that decision comes with, as it is still an unspoken norm of society, basically, that people in general, but especially women, have to actively want children, and if they decide not to have them, they are often portrayed as selfish, of being relentless career women. It often comes with a lot of negative prejudice against women who decide to do that. And this book very relatably tells the story of a woman who decides she does not want to have children, and the struggle she goes through as she continuously has to explain herself to her family, her friends, especially her best three friends, who she has been friends with since middle school, high school. They have been together all their life, but now at the time that they're all in their early 30s, all of her friends start to have children, or they already have children, or they're trying desperately to have children. And then she's on the completely other side of the spectrum, saying she actively does not want them. And even her friends kind of start to judge her for it, one could say, especially the friend that is actively trying to have children and it is not working out, calls her selfish and inconsiderate towards her feelings, whereas then our protagonist can say the same thing about the other friend. So basically the book picks up different aspects of those struggles her decision comes with, the friend side, having to explain herself to in front of her friends who are all opting for the children and marriage option, where she does not want to do that. Also, it deals with the struggles of having to end an otherwise very good relationship because her partner wants children and she does not want them, and the mixed feeling that comes with. At the same time, because our protagonist is a journalist, she's also doing research on the topic in general because she wants to write an article about it, about millennials or women in general opting for the childless option more and more because of the state of the world, basically. And so she does a lot of research on it as well and gets introduced into circles with like-minded women, but also men and non-binary people, of course. Are actively coming together because a lot of people who make this active decision to not want children themselves often find it hard to find like-minded people in their already existing group of friends or in their family. Because, yeah, I think, of course, it is undoubtedly nowadays the situation is way better than what it used to be 50 years ago. But at the same time, I think it is undeniable that there are still this prevailing norm that especially people with a uterus have to want children, and if they don't, it is kind of weird, but they have to explain themselves why they do not want them. When somebody says, yes, I want children, no one would follow up that question with a why do you want children, basically. But when somebody says, I do not want children, that is more likely to be followed up with a why don't you want children, basically. What I liked a lot about this book, and what I think everybody can take away from this book, no matter which side of the spectrum you're on, whether you want children, whether you don't want children, whether you're somewhere in between or you don't know yet, it doesn't matter. You can read this book, basically, because all of those different positions and the advantages and disadvantages those decisions come with, or the prejudices that each of those sides have to kind of fight with, are being highlighted equally in this book. Because the protagonist of this book is on the child-free end of the spectrum, but then again, there are a lot of people in this narrative that are actively opting for the other side of the spectrum. So each of it is equally represented, I would say, which was another plus point of this book. It is not like trying to convince the reader to not have children or something like that. Not at all. It is just telling the story of this woman who makes that decision and the bad conscience at times she has to fight with, the struggles of having to explain herself, not being taken seriously, because people always say, ah, you will change your mind, like when the right person comes along, you will want them, blah, blah, blah. Which all of those, even if they are said, those things are said meant in a nice way, they're at the same time not respecting her current opinion as an opinion in itself. It is always seen as like only a state of things that will still change to the right thing, basically. Like, oh yeah, down the line you will want it, or once the right partner comes along you will want them, don't you worry. Always portraying her opinion as still the wrong one, kind of. Those struggles, for example, this book picks up beautifully. So at the end of the day, this book is portraying different paths of life, because there aren't only two options, basically, whether you want children or you don't want children. There are many different paths in this life one could take. Not one path is any more right or wrong than another one. And one should never like try to force oneself down a certain path when that is not what one truly wants, because that would be the wrong decision for sure. As well as respecting each person's decision as they make them along their path. So basically, no matter whether you're in the process of trying to make a decision of that magnitude right now yourself, or whether you're just interested in the subject, or even like if you're like me, not in a place in your life where you're thinking about that right now, but still, it is a very interesting book to read as it talks about this question, which, as I said in the beginning, I have the feeling if you're not at least like actively doing research to like read about it, it is not a topic that is very often and openly discussed out there in general. And also, I have never yet encountered a book that solely revolves around that one question. So especially, of course, if you're someone who also has decided they want to live child-free in their life, I think this book would give you a lot of solace, because it would be written out of the perspective of a like-minded person, or at least it tells the story of a like-minded protagonist. But also, if you're from the other side of the spectrum, that you might feel that you do not really understand that point of view, definitely pick up this book as well, because it does a very good job of explaining Olive's point of view of not wanting children. I just thought this was such a special read, because it is a very important subject, a subject where there shouldn't be this prejudice about one option being the right one, other options being the wrong one, etc. But there should be more of a open, not even discussion, there's nothing really to discuss. Every person is allowed to do with their life whatever they want to do, without being judged by other people, without having to explain themselves. I think this book is a manifesto for that for sure. So please definitely read it. This looks like it's a very huge book, but I read this within a couple of days, because it was such a gripping story, and it's very accessible and very easy to read. This is only like published in 2020, so it's like modern day, relatable, contemporary people, you know. I can only recommend this to anyone and everyone out there. If you have things you want to talk about, if you have your own opinions about this book, leave them down below in the comment section. Otherwise, I will see you in my next video. Thank you for watching. Bye.